Metal detector. Vodka. Banana. Simp. So, how did you guys like that little Max Mofo intro thing? I don't know. Anyway, welcome everybody, welcome back to a brand new Nendoroid opening. It's been a while, I really enjoy doing those. I have no idea if you guys enjoy watching them, but at the end of the day, I'm gonna make them anyway, so it doesn't really matter. So this time, we'll be opening Nendoroid 751, Amelia from the anime RE0. I've absolutely been in love with RE0 lately, so I just had to get one of their Nendoroids. This is the first one I ordered. I also got some other ones on the way, like Beatrix, Rem, Ram. It's all gonna be fine. I'm still looking for the other ones because I wanna complete the collection. So yeah, I'm super, super excited to see how the figure looks outside of the box, see all the poses. So without further ado, let's jump straight into the unboxing. So without further ado, let's get into the box.
Baka, 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 baka.
And here we have Amelia out of the box. First of all, I absolutely love the sculpting on it. I also really like this random piece of hair that they decided to put on. I love the fact that the ribbon is able to move and even if you really wanted to, can be removed. That's a nice touch. Only problem I have with the figure from the start is that there is so much hair that it's kind of impossible to move the head around, which really limits posing. So that's something to keep in mind right away. As for the extra accessories that she comes with two extra bent arms, which are always appreciated when posing the character. One of the arms even has a little extra joint at the end, giving it even more articulation in posing. And that is absolutely amazing and very much appreciated. She also comes with three of her magic ice crystals, which is pretty cool. One is pretty big and the other one are the same smaller size. And holding them in my hand like this, let me tell you, these things are sharp and they actually hurt my hand right now. Probably one of the cutest accessories she comes with is that she comes with Puck, which is pretty cool. It's always nice to get another small companion or other character included while you buy an Nendoroid. So I'm really going to enjoy posing Puck with Amelia. It is important to note that Puck does have articulation in his head, so you can make him look all different kinds of ways, which is always a cool thing. She also comes with like a ton and a ton of clear stands to hold up her icicles, hold up Puck, and hold up any other accessory that you wanna hold up. It's absolutely insane. I have never gotten so many clear standards. Oh my god. But probably the coolest accessory I have ever received with a Nendoroid ever is the special cape that she wears in the show to hide her identity. I absolutely love the fact that they included this. This is such a nice inclusion. And wow, it looks epic. I love this. What an awesome accessory. And I can't wait to use it on other characters too. It's just a shame that the hair is stuck to the hood, making it a little bit more difficult to use on other Nendoroids. As for the faces, Amelia comes with a gentle smile as her default face. An angry face for attacking poses or to have her pose next to Subaru, and probably my least favorite faceplate I have ever received. This looks hideous. I absolutely hate this faceplate. I know that she's crying and stuff, but man, it looks bad. I absolutely despise this faceplate. Probably never going to use it. But oh well, it's still a faceplate, I guess. On the topic of faceplates, there is something really important to note about Emilia's faceplates. And that is because she is an elf, which means she got elf ears, which might prevent you from using her head on other Nendroids. So it is something to keep in mind. So the first pose I did was the basic default pose that she comes with. It is pretty easy to do because it showcases Puck and Emilia's gentle smile. Even though it's pretty simple, I actually quite like this one as it really fits her character in the show. So the second pose that we did was her crying pose. And like I have expressed, I absolutely hate the faceplate. What I absolutely do love though is the fact that she grabs the crystal around her neck, trying to seek comfort from Puck, which is absolutely an amazing touch to this pose. As for the third pose, I posed her in the attacking pose. And I do gotta say, it looks super cool. However, this has to be said, me personally, I am just not a fan of all the transparent plastic around the crystals. It takes away way more than the crystals and you don't even notice them that much. Yeah, I feel like I should have went with a different solution for the attack, but the pose itself is pretty cool. And for the final pose, and my absolutely favorite pose that the character can do, I decided to put on the cloak. I know in the original pose, Puck isn't there, but I really wanted to include him as he isn't in a lot of poses. I absolutely love this pose, and this will be the pose I will be displaying the figure in most of the time. Oh man, I love this pose. You've probably already heard me say it in the unboxing part. I love this pose. This is seriously so cool with the accessories, with like the cloak and stuff. I love this figure. I'm super happy with it. Even though Emilia isn't my favorite character in the world, I still really like the figure. It did a really good job and it got me even more hyped to receive the Rem figure, to receive the Beatrix figure. It's gonna be super cool and I can't wait to collect them all and I'll put them in the case. Anyway guys, thank you all so much for watching me being a weep. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye bye!